traveling alone? Now, now, no threat here. Just here to chat.
And why is that?
Well, not many people travel by boat on their own. It can be quite a lonely voyage. But I've found those that do tend to have the more interesting stories.
Maybe it's just better for some people to be alone.
Maybe. But with your paranoia, I think a few friendly faces wouldn't hurt.
Who says I'm paranoid?
No one, dear. No one. I'll leave you be. But, fair warning. These trips can be awfully boring.
Won't be needing this.
Something this big. But we'll give her a fight nonetheless.
Well, it looks like you can use all the help you can get.
Ugh. Just shut up and fight.
man!
Starboard defenses are down, sir.
We still got the heavy cannon?
Aye, but it's moving too fast. We can't land a hit.
How about the engines?
Fully functional, Captain.
Well, all right then. Huntsman! If you can clip its wings and draw it out towards the bow, we can take it!
I mean, you're the one with the swords. Now or never! Part where you say it. Okay, maybe later. Just enjoy the rest of your trip and everything will be cool. We got this. You'd think they'd never seen a fight before.
What are you doing here, son?
Digging the new outfit, by the way. Never did like the bow.
Son!
Jeez!
Have you been following me?
I saw you run off. The night Beacon Tower fell. Once we landed in Vale, you made sure everyone was okay, and then you just took off without saying anything.
I had to. You wouldn't understand.
No, I get it. The moment you left, I knew exactly what you were doing. You're going on a one-woman rampage against the White Fang!
What?
You've always felt like the Fang was your fight. They show up, trash your school, hurt your friends. It makes perfect sense.
I can't believe you.
But there's no way I'm letting you do this alone. It's an honorable approach for sure, but you're gonna need someone watching your back. And that's where I come in. Us Faunus gotta stick together after all.
You're wrong, son. You're so, so wrong.
What are you...
I'm not going anywhere near the White Fang. Not yet.
Seriously?
I need to sort some things out.
Then why not do it with your team? Your friends!
You're one to talk. Assuming Neptune, Sage, and Scarlet aren't hiding below deck.
You really think I could get Neptune on the ocean? They flew back to Mistral. I told them I'd catch up. Not the first time I left them to take a boat. So, if you're not going after the White Fang, where are you going?
Home. To Menagerie.
Well, I'm coming with you. The Grimm are getting worse. You saw it yourself. And just because you're not going after the Fang doesn't mean they won't be coming for you. Besides, I'm kinda already on the boat.
There's really no stopping you.
Nope! This is gonna be great. Never been to Menagerie before. It'll be a regular journey to the east. Yeah, I like the sound of that.
Mm-hmm.
never seen so many Faunus in one place.
This is the one place everyone can feel safe, no matter who or what they are.
Wow. Sure is, crowded, huh?
Yes. Yes, it is.
Is it always so cramped?
Well, when you try and take an entire species and put them on an island that's two-thirds desert, yeah, it tends to be cramped.
What? You guys have that much more space? Why waste it? A little desert never hurt anyone.
It's not like the desert in Vacuo, son. The wildlife here is more dangerous than most other regions.
So they gave us a terrible island in the corner of Remnant to try and shut us up.
That's a pretty good summary, yeah.
Huh. Jerks.
We've tried to make the best of things.
Whoa.
This is Kuokuana.
It's beautiful. I take it all back. This place looks great. Why would anyone ever want to leave?
That's not the point, son. We asked to be equal, to be treated just like everyone else. Instead, we were given an island and told to make do. So we did the best we could. We came together and we made a home where any Faunus could feel welcome. But this island, this town, will always be a reminder that we're still not equal. That we're still second-class citizens.
Well, hey, this guy's feeling pretty at home.
All right, time to go home.
Oh yeah? Which one's yours? Can you see it from here?
Kind of.
Is it that one? What about that tiny one down there? I like the paint job.
It's that one.
What is it?
It's just been a long time since I've seen my parents.
Well, you came all this way. Okay, if we're being honest, that's kind of intimidating.
Blake?
Hi, Mom.
My baby girl.
Holly, who is it?
We were horrified when we heard the news. The Kingdom of Vale wasn't perfect, but it certainly didn't deserve what happened. We were both so worried.
Please, I knew she'd be fine.
That isn't the slightest bit true. You should have seen him pacing.
You guys have nothing to worry about. I've seen your daughter in action before, and trust me, she's got some moves.
And what exactly do you mean by that, Mr. Wukong?
You see, sir, it's just that...
You know, she's such a good fighter and all. And as a fellow fighter, I have a lot of respect for
her. Why is he here again?
But also for her.
Followed me home.
She's not good looking.
I see.
Or slightly?
She's definitely above average. I mean, this tea is really good. Huh?
I like him.
Mom!
Darn it, I completely forgot about the meeting.
Gira,
Give me a moment.
Is everything okay?
Yes, dear, just poor timing. He can reschedule. It's just been hard dealing with them lately.
Dealing with who?
The White Fang.
What? Dad!
Blake, what's wrong?
Miss Belladonna.
We had no idea you'd returned.
What are you doing talking to these people?
This is Corsic and Fennec Albane. They represent the White Fang here in Menagerie now.
Those psychos are here too?
Young man, I'm not sure what you've heard of our organization, but I can assure you we're not nearly as ferocious as the media would have you believe.
What we've heard? We've seen firsthand. Your fanatics slaughtered people.
What is she talking about?
Precisely what we came to discuss with you, Your Grace.
Is everything all right?
Wait, you guys seriously don't know?
Know what?
The White Fang was at the fall of Beacon. They attacked innocent civilians, and they released Grimm into the school.
Is this true?
Sadly, Your Grace, it is.
Don't act like
you're... That's enough! Explain yourselves.
Though it pains us to admit, it has become apparent that the Vale branch of the White Fang is no longer operating under orders of High Leader Khan. Rather, they've elected to follow the rule of one Adam Taurus. I believe you're all familiar with the young adept and his extreme philosophies.
You know, Beacon wasn't the first time the Fang started shooting up Vale.
The High Council had their suspicions of a splinter group, but they could prove nothing until this latest incident.
Incident? People are dead.
And it is a tragedy.
Your Grace, we came to assure you that Brother Taurus and his followers do not represent the will of the White Fang.
And how can I be sure of that?
We understand if you bear any skepticism towards these claims. The White Fang's tactics are admittedly more aggressive since you stepped down as High Leader and became Chieftain of Menagerie. But this is no way to make our message heard.
We have ample documentation from the council meeting as well as several strategies to apprehend and punish these strays if you'd care to review them.
I will, but another day. I'd like some time to reconnect with my daughter.
But of course, Your Grace.
We completely understand. It was a pleasure to see you again, young Blake.
We were saddened when we heard of your departure from the White Fang. But understand if you can no longer support our cause.
It is a wearying fight, after all.
Who says I'm done fighting?
If you ever do wish to return, you need merely come find us.
Sister Ilya would be elated.
Goodbye, gentlemen.
So, those guys were creepy.
I really don't like you.
An interesting development, wouldn't you say?
Interesting indeed.
So, shall we inform Brother Adam?
We shall.
You know, you can always go in and say hi.
I don't want to bother him.
A father's never too busy for his daughter.
Not all of my friends would agree with you on that.
Here.
What? Where are you going?
You've never been very talkative, but that boy you brought home loves to run his mouth. I want to hear more about the adventures of Team RWBY.
Collie, is that you, dear?
Dad.
Blake! Well, this is a pleasant surprise.
I...
Please, come sit. Don't worry, I've got it. Sit down, sit down.
I don't want to keep you if you're...
Nonsense. I've been cooped up in here all day. You still take sugar, right?
Oh,
sorry.
No, it's fine.
Oh, here, take this one.
No, really, it's no big deal.
You sure?
Positive.
Old habits, I suppose. Might want to let it cool.
Right.
So, is it warm in Vale?
Huh?
It just seems like your outfit doesn't cover very much.
It covers plenty.
I mean, a little more armor might help, don't you think?
I'm fine. I don't need armor. I can look after myself.
I know you can. I'm sorry.
Why? Why would you say that?
Sweetheart, what's wrong? What did I say?
How can you still love me after what I did?
Blake. Your mother and I will always love you.
You were right. I shouted at you and yelled at you, but you were right. I called you cowards.
It's okay.
I should have left the White Fang with you and Mom. I should have listened to you, and I'm sorry. I'm so, so sorry.
Blake, it's fine. We never held anything against you. And I never feared you would fail. The only thing I ever feared was that you would fall down the wrong path. And I am so proud to see you haven't.
But I did. It was...
And you pulled yourself out. You came back. There aren't many who possess that kind of strength, and even fewer that have the courage to face their demons again. Vale, Mountain Glen, Beacon. You confronted the White Fang time after time.
I didn't do it alone.
No, you didn't. Which is why I wanted to ask you. Why did you leave Vale? Why did you leave your friends behind?
I... Son?
Whoa! This isn't the bathroom! I'll just be going. Sorry to interrupt this tender family moment.
I really don't like you.
Ugh. No concept of privacy. No respect for personal space.
I'm sorry, okay? Ow! I'm sorry!
Ugh.
Look, I promise it was important. I needed to find you to talk to you.
What, son? What could be so important?
I was talking to your mom, and she said something weird about the White Fang.
I'm stopping you right there.
But...
I told you. I'm not here to fight the White Fang. I'm not here to fight anyone. I'm here to rest, to figure things out, and to see my family.
Your mom said White Fang members don't wear masks in Menagerie, but I saw one at the market yesterday. I even got a picture.
Son.
Look, I'm trying to help.
I don't want your help.
A freaking ninja?
A spy.
But why would... Hey, wait!
What's happened?
The White Fang is evil, I totally called it, and I'm bringing your daughter back!
Gotcha!
Hey, wait up!
be watching me.
Give it up! I'm not above hitting a girl, you know. Grab the scroll! Seems someone thinks it's important.
Get...
Quit staring and grab it! Buddy, watch out!
Ilya.
Wait, you know her? But she doesn't even look like a fool!
Give it to me. No. You shouldn't have come back. Son! Son! No, 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 not again, please. Help! Somebody! Hold on, son. Just hold on.
Blake?
This is why, son. This is why I left them all behind.
What are you... Wait. Where am I?
I am done seeing my friends hurt because of me.
Blake!
Shut up! Do you think I like being alone? Every day. Every day I think about them. RWBY, Weiss, Yang. They were my friends. I love them like I never thought I could love anybody. And I hope they hate me for leaving.
You don't mean that.
Yes, I do! Everyone thinks they can help me, but they can't. You saw Ilya last night, and she's not even the worst. No. No more. They're better off without me. I made my choices, and I'll deal with the consequences, because they belong to me.
You think you're being selfless, but you're not. Yeah. That chameleon friend of yours got me pretty good. But I'd do it all again if it meant protecting you. And I can promise Yang would say the same. You can make your own choices, sure. But you don't get to make ours. When your friends fight for you, it's because we want to. So stop pushing us out. That hurts more than anything the bad guys could ever do to us. But if it makes you feel any better, the next time I go up against Lizard Girl, it won't be for you. It'll be to get even.
My hero. Oh, oh dear, would you look at that? He's awake. Thank goodness.
Kali, please.
Mom?
Hey, Mrs. B.
What are you doing?
Well, sweetheart, your father needed to speak with the two of you.
Huh?
I'm afraid you were right to be suspicious.
What do you mean?
Adam Taurus is planning to overthrow the leader of the White Fang and stage a full-scale attack on Haven Academy. It will be the fall of Beacon all over again.
Not if we destroy the White Fang once and for all.
No. We're not going to destroy the White Fang. We're going to take it back.
You and Dad. Handwritten stuff's never been super reliable, but I guess it's all we've got these days. Anyway, in case you haven't been getting them, I want to say I'm sorry for leaving the way I did. I know you told me it was a reckless idea, and after everything I've been through, I can definitely say you were right. It's been hard. On all of us. And I'm not just talking about the monsters we fought out here.
Okay, you can hide out back in the cargo hold. I'll take you as far as I can, but if we get caught, you're on your own. Understand?
Every step we made took us further and further away from the things we knew. And every morning we woke up wondering if just over the next hill would be something good. Or something terrible. It's scary, not knowing what's going to happen next. And the things we do know now, just how bad it can get, it almost makes it all worse. You told me once that bad things just happen. You were angry when you said it, and I didn't want to listen. But you were right. Bad things do happen. All the time. Every day. Which is why I'm out here. To do whatever I can, wherever I can, and hopefully do some good. We've all lost something. And I've seen what loss can do to people. But if we gave up every time we lost, then we'd never be able to move forward. We'd never have a chance to see what beautiful things the future might have waiting for us. We'd never have the strength to change, whether it's ourselves or the world around us. And we'd never be there for other people who might one day be lost without us. This is what we were training for, Yang. To become huntresses. To be the ones to stand up and do something about all the bad in the world.
Approaching City of Mistral.
Because there are plenty of people out there who are still lost. And even more who will try to gain everything they can from their sorrow. Believe me when I say, I know it can feel impossible. Like every single day is a struggle against some unstoppable monster we can never hope to beat. But we have to try. If not for us, then for the people we've already... than for the people we haven't lost yet. I miss you so much. I miss Weiss and Blake too. But I think you'd all be proud to know that I made it to Mistral. All of us did. And we even ran into Uncle Crow along the way.
Hey, aren't I normally the one saving you?
He's going to take us to see Professor Lionheart, the headmaster of Haven Academy. And he told us some things that you're gonna want to hear. Things I can't trust will make it to you in this letter. But maybe, if you joined us, he could tell you himself. With Beacon gone, they'll need Dad at Signal more than ever. And I know you need to focus on yourself before I can expect you to come out with me. But it sure would be great to get Team RWBY back together again.
You are in so much trouble when I find you.
Until next time, your loving sister, RWBY Rose. P.S. I'll be sure to give you the address of where we'll be staying in Mistral. I'd love to hear back from you and Dad, and I can't wait to fill you in on whatever's going to happen next. Now that we've made it across Anima, I really think things are going to start going our way.
Why, thank you, Professor. Salem always did say you were quite hospitable.
We'll be right back.